got the covers off. So this side, which is the driver's side, we'll call it the left, running a little bit leaner, starting to clean up. But the other side, the right side, not so much. But, you know, it's to be expected. We're going to clean those a little bit later. I'm going to put them, just thread them back in. I hit them with the wire wheel first. Right. This is the camera in automatic, and it doesn't do well in automatic, but if you put a little light on it, it helps. But it won't focus as well. Right. So we'll stick it in our thing there, and I'm going to start. I got to hold it, so I got to put the camera down. Otherwise, it might shoot out. Gap was way out. It's like almost 35. I think the manual is 25. I got them to like 28. Because they'll probably open up again. Let me get some anti-seize on that and we'll put them in. See, look, it's just a screw right there. And then a little nut on the other side. So I believe that's the right position. So I'm going to grab a Phillips head and a wrench. And I'm just going to tighten that up and we'll check it. So it's not just a screw. What's happening is this bracket holds it on. It's not one of those keyed crush clamps, right? What's happening is it's just, when you tighten it, it's just sliding on here because the vinyl came off. What I'm thinking of doing is we're gonna put some heat shrink on, right? And then there's a little cap too. Look at the cap. Now I was gonna try putting a cap on it beforehand, but if we do that, we're gonna need to lubricate. So I think we're gonna leave the cap till later, because we're gonna wanna put a little bit more lubricant in this sheath. So let me heat this up with the heat gun, right? And we'll try sliding this back on, and then maybe also with a bigger washer or something. I don't know, we'll see. We gotta see how it works out. So let's get it set up with the heat gun first. Too windy for a lighter. I could use a torch, but not here, right? And this should grip it. It's not as thick, so maybe one more layer. Yeah, let me get another one. I'd like to have this in the garage, but it's nice out. It's windy though out here. That fits better, but I crimped it down. The hole is a little misaligned. So, just gonna try to move it up a little. Running out of light now. When you do this, you're realigning it somewhat. That's better. Okay, now I'm gonna try to stick it in. That's what she said. That's what he said. Alright, try to come up, put the battery cable down. And it went this way. Yeah, that's better. Okay, let's try getting the screws. Not the best hardware, but it'll do for now. We can always try it to fix it up again. Yeah, but unfortunately you're staring at my bald head. There we go. Okay, now, it feels about right. It's about where I want it here. We want to adjust it a little bit. Loosen it a little. Try to pull the sheath. Yeah, I don't know if I'm going to be able to pull the sheath now. That's one of the problems.
A few moments later.
So what I did was just opening it up a little bit, and then I'm gonna move it down. Not all the way to the end, just a little bit. So now I should be able to move it. Yeah, I'm moving it. Just enough, that should do it. Right, because it was hitting, the lever was hitting the end of the cable. So right here should be where we want it. And let's reattach it. We got to adjust it here. See, the clamp is off the hose. That's not good. It's in the wrong spot. Do the choke cable. So the primer dried. Probably could have put black on it too, but we'll do that next time. Now let's loosen this. So I need to be able to move this all the way forward. And that's pretty much forward. And that's all the way forward. So the throttle is forward, right? And now let's go back. And so my lever hits the stop on the dash. This looks good here, right? And the throttle is down. This is loose, this throttle is loose. What's going on with that? Yeah, that's not good. Somebody's been in this. It looks like the end, something happened to the end of this. Now, so our throttle is here, right? So this is a bracket that's like an extension bracket. It's like a lever bracket. So we're all the way idle and we're good here. And now we're full throttle there. And then of course, this is the governor. So the governor's gonna modulate it. So we're good, okay? But now we can put the battery in, we can do the plug. So I'll be back. I'm gonna go deal with the plugs now. I'm gonna run the ISO on auto. Now for outside, sometimes you're better off with auto. You know, run the camera in auto because there's just so much shading and shadowing. Here, one plug in, let me get the wrench. Now these are flange style plugs. In other words, they have a seat. There's no gasket. So you tighten them differently. You're not, I always say crush it down, crush the gasket. There's no gasket. So you should just tighten it. You should never feel it loosening again. You know, that kind of feeling. That's it, right there. Looks cool with the fins. All right, that's done. Take a peek in here. I'll blow a little bit of silicone in that. Put that on, put the plug wires on, a little silicone. And then I gotta let it down too, and then we'll put the battery in. We'll put a little no-seize on these screws. Just gonna put, you know what, I might leave them out for now. I don't want this flapping around, but we want to be able to get to the carburetor, so maybe just put one in. You know, because I don't want it flopping, and I'll tighten it. Because I want to be able to get in there. I don't want to lose it either into the engine. Well, this needs to be, this thing, the cable here, needs to be attached. But we're just going to clean these terminals, and I'm going to put a little no-seize on that. They're not great, but they're not terrible. We can always clean them up again another time. But this is fine. And then I'm going to do the tops of the battery post. And then we'll put a little bit of that lead no-seize on. Yeah, they were pretty bad. All right, half inch wrench. Put the positive on first. Suppose you could lift this up and go like that. Seems like it doesn't want to go on like that. It wants to be here. It wants to be more like here. Yeah. And then you're going to have to turn that like that. Probably should tap that. That's better. Just snug it up. Run out of light. I'd like to try to bring it in. All right, so that's in. Hopefully it'll hold it. Now this guy, that guy we need to fix, and this guy I think we're just gonna come around like this. There's no other good way. So we may have to reroute that. Done. All right, we're gonna give it a start up. I think we're good to go. All right, it has oil in it. I don't think we need anything else, guys. Let's give it a start. And we're gonna try pulling out the parking brake. Okay, we'll pull choke. That's pretty stiff. And I think that's it. We got a little bit of choke out. Should be able to give it a kick, and it shouldn't need to do anything else. Take the choke in a little. Choke out. Right, probably wet, so. Could be water in it. All right, let's give it some help. Put a little bit of smoke fuel in there. You know, I got the ignition wet. And I don't really know much about that. So, you know, who knows? You could fry stuff. Okay. There you go. There we go. Give it some RPM. Almost. It's got water in it. Sucking water.
See? We don't want to do that too much until we change the oil and clean the carburetor out. We don't really know what the hell's going on with that. And it actually killed itself, so let's see what's going on.
So back on the tractor, I was working on it the other night. It wouldn't start. You know, remember, I washed it. So it wouldn't start. So I put a Ford solenoid in it. The solenoid seemed to be bad. So I think it's a coincidence of problems, right? So I put the Ford solenoid in it. Actually, this goes here, right? That's accessory. So the blue wire, I did find some information on it. The blue wire is your start wire, right? Coming from the harness. So I relocated all of this. And it, in a way, it's kind of nice because I put the battery on the post here, then with a nut, all right? That's the B-positive lead. Then the accessory wires that go to the B-positive, right? So on a separate nut. So anytime you want to add something, right, you can just take this one nut off and add it and put it back. You're not disrupting the positive battery cable. And I moved the solenoid over to here, and it's just far enough away on this end of it, because this is just the start end, so that's, you know, the only time it could arc is when you were starting it, but it's far enough away from everything. Figured out what this is. This is part of the accessory pack. These are just ground tabs. And this is actually a diagnostic port. So I'm not sure what all of this is, but I started cleaning this. So we're going to wrap this up later, right? We're going to rewrap that. But the other problem here is in here. So I cleaned up the ignition switch. Now, I think I might clean it again. I think what we're going to do is we're going to immerse this as well. I did clean the contacts, but I think it's a good time to maybe immerse it. In the kerosene diesel. I forget what that stuff is. I think it's diesel. I don't remember. Diesel is good, too. Now, these are the contacts for the PTO switch. And again, hopefully you can see that. So what I did was I blew them out with compressed air, and then I put in some brake cleaner, and then I'm putting in some of my acid. And this is Alumabrite, right? It's a little different than the body acid. And now this one I actually sprayed already with chain wax. Chain wax is really good. But it got wet again, so I might as well just wet it again. I'm going to walk away, leave that sit, all right? But it has nothing to do with the problem. Now, I want to show you, you can see up in here, these are the reed switches, micro switches, and I think you can see it. Hold on. I'm hoping you can. There they are, there. I don't think you're not focusing, though, on them. Unfortunately, I can't get you focused. But they're up in here, and I'm going to show you from up top. All right, so when you pull back, see those little metal tangs? Yeah, see, because I'm not in the shop. So I bent those out a little bit more. And when you turn the key on, what will happen, what you're looking for, is when you turn the key on, right, you should get a neutral switch. And that light should be on. Okay, when the transmission is in neutral. So by bending those metal tangs out a little bit, just carefully, I was able to sort of get that to happen again. So the problem is in the switches, and I can also tell by this switch on the outside is a switch down here. It wasn't being depressed fully. It's not it's depressed. So we want to get up in there and pull those wires out as well. But I figured, let me stay on the PTO switch and the main ignition switch, put that back properly back in to the machine, and then we got one more thing to do, which is come up in here and take these wires off. Now, we may want to take the battery out for that. We'll go take the battery out again so I can climb in there, and same procedure, clean everything off, I'll lubricate the switches with some Croil or some PB Blaster, and exercise them, clean the contacts, acid etch them, blow them off, and then spray chain wax in there, which will help protect them, keep them clean and lubricated, and the contacts good, and protect the metal, because it sets up like a wax, so it's really nice. So that's today's agenda, along with getting rid of the Mazda today. All right, so we'll be back. I'll keep you guys updated. All right, so I checked out the PTO switch, and we'll do it again. But what I did was, I cleaned it in my solvent. And then I put it in here, and you could see the bubbles. See the bubbles? Yeah. All right, so I'm going to move it around back and forth. It seems to be working, but it was really stiff. And the other option is to actually immerse it in some acid, like the phosphoric acids that I use. But this is better. It doesn't need that. If the contacts seem to be fine, it's working. So I'm going to just put it in there again, move it around. I'm going to take it out and blow it, do that a couple of times, and that'll dissolve any of the junk, and it's moving easier. And then I may immerse it in some just oil, motor oil, and then let it drain out, sit in the sun or whatever, and we'll move it through. Because there's actually a bit of grease in these things. But my experiences with taking these things apart is they don't go back together. So I think this is a good way to do it. All right, guys, I just want to show real quick, you know, I have other lessons on this, but just while we're here, right? I'm going to put my ohm meter in beep mode, right? That's continuity. I've also immersed this in transmission fluid, right? And let it bubble up. And this is used transmission fluid. I have so much of it because I had an issue with one of the trucks that I had. The solenoids were giving me problems, so I had to keep taking it apart. So it's good. Transmission fluid is really good for stuff like this because it has a it's an excellent lubricant, and it has a lot of detergents in it. So it just it's much smoother now, and the contacts will polish up as you move them. So now let's just check them electrically again, okay? So this is a double pole, double throw switch, right? So it's got two poles on it. So it actually has two sets of contacts on it. And in the middle is the common. So on this one, the reason why you see this one here is it doesn't have one on the other side. That's in part two, so that you can install the switch in a particular way, right? They don't want you to stick the switch and its connectors in and screw anything up. So they'll do that sometimes, but there could have been one there. So when the switch is in this position, right, when the rocker faces, let's say, in the opposite direction, generally what it does is it rocks, okay? So when you move the switch like this, it'll actually fire that contact, right? It'll actually make contact with the contact over here. And we don't have one over there. So what we should see is nothing on this contact, all right? So we know the beeper works, right? See, nothing. Now when we throw the switch this way, okay, now this contact here will beep, all right? And we're going to do the same thing on this side. So that's the center. So just check your meter. So now it should be making this contact, which it is, but not this one, which it's not. Now we'll got to lift the switch up in this case. It has a safety on it. See? So this switch is good. All right, so we're going to install this now. And I'm going to take out my ignition switch and clean that off before we do that. Sorry for the noise. There's always something going on. So I blew this out. This I had previously cleaned in a little bit of acid. So the contacts are nice. Nice and clean. I got off any debris and check them to make sure that they're pinned well, right? Because they're actually riveted down. And so after soaking it again, I just blew it out. I did it a couple of times. First, I did it in the diesel or kerosene. It feels nice. All right, so now I'm going to take them out to the tractor, and we're going to install both of these. So we know these are good, right? This shouldn't be a problem. Everything seems to be working now, so this is not our issue, and this is not our issue, right? So when I go to troubleshoot the PTO, I may have to take the connectors back off, but I know the issue is not in the switch. This might have even had a little light or something on it. All right, so let's bring them out. This has been sitting with that acid on it for a while. In fact, I even grabbed a bite to eat. Yeah, it's pretty dry. Before I install, grab your chain wax fill them up. They're nice and clean. Like I said, we're probably going to have to take this back off, but, you know, for our purposes now, no. All right, so I'm going to lean in there. This goes to the ignition switch. These two here go to the PTO. So I'm going to lean up in there. I'm going to move you guys out of the way. You're not going to be able to see anything. Let me reinstall that, and then we'll see what gives. Now, I noticed that there's this supply wire here. So, and then there's that connector. So I cleaned off that connector. I'm going to put the Lumibrite on that. We'll put a little Lumibrite on this, too. And then we'll wipe everything off. And I have some other stuff to do. I got to keep working on that Mazda. So we'll let that sit, all right? And I'll come back in about 15 and install that. Okay, we're all set. Now it's back in. Now you're going to see, all right, there's the neutral light. See, now it cranks. And then I'm going to move the speed control, all right, transmission control over, and we're going to break the contacts on those little reed switches. Okay? You can hear them clicking. Okay? All right, so we're good now. Now, I noticed if you shook it a little bit, if you shook, he said shake the PTO switch, but what was actually happening was is he was shaking something, like the whole tractor essentially, shaking the wiring in that area, and it was causing the connection to make and break. So we're still going to go in, and we're going to pull the battery a little bit later, and we're going to clean the contacts on the back of these reed switches. But another thing too is don't forget to put a little bit of chain wax in there, all right? And I did the same thing in the ignition switch. I just pushed some chain wax right in, and you're all good to go. And, you know, I'm going to chain wax the rest of it, too, when I get to it. But I got to get back to work on the Mazda. That's a nice car. You know, I feel bad. So, essentially, I traded that Mazda for this ugly, rude thing. But, you know, I can only handle so much, especially right now. I'm overwhelmed. That muffler's ready to fall off. All right, let me get back to work.
1 hour later.
The old girl or guy, I don't know yet. See, to neutral. Got a little bit of a fart. We'll get it out. Let's check the lights. See, now the seat light is on. It shouldn't be on, but it is. Let's see if it has lights. Come back one, I think. Got one light. But that means the circuit works. You don't need brakes, so I just want to put it in reverse just a little bit. It's kind of sticky, so it should be holding on. Take the brake off. Spider, go away. Get out of here, you. I gotta get the bugs out. Now, we'll go forward. Oh. It's a little jerky, and this is stiff. Turn a little bit of throttle off. That. Oh, that must be a bad spot. Yeah. I'm not happy with that. Okay, we're stuck. Alright, so push the brake. I guess it doesn't like that throttle position. It needs some work. I was guessing it. Let's see. Let's pull some choke out. Pull some more choke. There we go. Choke in. It wanders a little bit, see? It creeps a little bit. And that needle is down. But I got voltage. Alright, let's give it a little bit of throttle. A little bit of forward motion. Gonna move the shift right. Jerky right now. Until I get through the machine, that the levers are difficult to move. You put that brake on, you better hold on. It almost doesn't even need brakes because it just stops as soon as you pull it into neutral or slow it down. It becomes that speed. All right, we'll be back. We'll do some more another day. Not even really that hot. It's been running for a while. That cools well. Old boy. You're old like me. I just quickly cleaned the air filter, pre-filter. I bought some air filters for it, but they were the wrong size. So I just cleaned the pre-filter. That's what was really dirty. I guess somebody had done some things to this. But I put, this is kerosene, and the drawer was almost full. Right, so I put about the width of the label into the engine before I change the oil. I'm going to run this for a little bit. I ordered the filter and oil, and hopefully all that comes and it's correct. So we're going to just, you know, as I run it here and there, I'm going to do a few things and enjoy the machine a little bit and run it around and move it back and forth, and then I'll drop the oil. And that's an old trick. We used to use gunk engine flush years ago, particularly for fresh acquisitions of older things, right? Older cars. You go buy a car, it's an older car, and it's questionable. The oil is dirty. Maybe the valves are a little ticky, and, you know. So it's a sludge remover, essentially. All right, so that's it. I'm going to start this thing up and just move it out of here for the day.
Later.
All right, we got it loaded. There's Mikey peeking out over there. It's looking good. He's got the lights on. Nice, you got the lights on.
In the grill,
that's awesome.
That light is blinding right now, but not.
Actually, if you look at those lights, I can feel it in my eyes.
And it's bright out. Look in the grill.
That's sweet.
You gonna miss her?
Yeah, a little bit. Get it! Alright guys, end of day report. Alright, I did get it in here. Alright, it's weird going up the ramp. But lower RPM, a little bit of transmission engagement, and it just goes. It doesn't care, right? So, but I couldn't get it on the ramp because it's pushing the ramp, it's sliding. Now, I don't know how much air pressure is in these tires, and they are two different tires, and I am approaching it at an angle. So it was sliding and pushing the ramp down, and I'm too tired to fool with it. This is one of those moments where I wish I kind of bought the bigger lift. Now, that lift is good for 1,000 pounds. This is about 800, right, without the deck on it. So as it sits right here, right? But it's going to turn around that he wants that car that I'm not going to use. It's kind of keeping it for, like, in case my van died or whatever, just in case, because I don't have much money. So we're just going to do an even, an even trade up. So essentially getting my shed car out of here off the property. It's another car off the property. And this is the trade. So some horse trading, guys. I think that's pretty cool. This is a fun thing, right? He'll get his money back plus
on that. Anyway, I'm rambling on. I'll keep you guys posted on this, and there'll be more videos on this. We're going to basically restore the thing, and we're going to make all the implements for it. And speaking of my daughter, here she is right now. Come on, Christina, say goodbye to everybody out in YouTube land.
You're at 8.
Yeah, at 8. All right, guys, go step in the frame. Yes, there's the love of my life. All right, guys, I'll see you guys in the next one, and stay tuned for more. Yay! Arch's Garage.
I'm literally wearing Christmas PJs. Thank you.